Hebel als Schild!
Ja!
Nächste Point!
将近50年前，我已经黑带子了。那时候没有奥运，我的学生打了奥运金牌。我教跆拳道教45年以上，已经是祖师爷级了。那时候全美东地区就是只有我一家中国人开的跆拳道馆。在梦中里面看到的那情景，就是现今的学生。离我想要达到的目标还很远很远很远，所以我接着说这个才起步。真的很担心，心理上没有接班人的问题、助手的问题、教练的问题。
I've been training in school since I was 11 years old, and I started probably teaching classes when I was 14 or 15 years old.
Push yourself.
The one thing that I really learned from him is that when you really feel passionate about one thing, it's in your heart. There is no life challenge that you cannot conquer. For him, it all starts with martial arts. He's a Taiwan national champion. BABS is a complete different skill set. Mas Wan was basically a first-time business owner. He was trying to figure out how to run a business and how to still have the martial arts values throughout the school. It took him right now 32 years to figure it out, and I think he's still working on figuring it out.
最早开始开道馆是在加拿大，加拿大那边有很多的回忆，但是我开道馆来很辛苦，最辛苦的一段日子。我在还没出发之前的前一个礼拜，刚好我们跆拳道协会开会，我说我现在要去抢滩登陆亚美利坚共和国，打不死我一定带领你们共同登陆这一块处女地。后来才知道，哇，原来是这回事，真的是没有暖气，没有冷气，地下室那窗户这么小一个，打开的时候那血有时候飘到你脸上，又把你叫醒回来，关起来又怕闷死在里面，因为很小，房空间很小很小，怕闷死在里面，所以呢每两个小时都转闹钟转一次，把自己叫醒过来啊，然后再去睡觉，再忍两个小时再叫醒自己。
当人在受苦的时候，不会觉得自己那时候受苦，都是常常是过后回头想说：“哎呦，这种生活怎么我可以支撑得了呢？”才走过来。
每次经过那边的时候，就叫143号。 创业开始都是很辛苦的，要收入第一个学生最辛苦。那时候总共才六个学生而已，大家都像真的是像我们师徒制这样子。那个时候教学生在同的时候是打骂教育的，我越骂你是越好的，是表示我重视你。因为现在学生年龄层越小，他不一定接受你这种观念。我如果教课，保证学生跑到没一个。以前那枪上的学生跟自己家人一模一样的，跟现在的学生，我也许很多都不认识。过去的没办法再回顾了，对不对？有时候真的是有一种看现在的情况，有很多会怀念对过去的那段情感，那种很浓厚的情感啊，那革命情感。在我们以前那个年代是师傅跟徒弟，我们这边只有学生跟教练。从跆拳道来讲，其实离我理想差太多太多了，千分之一都不到。
Yes, I never tell you. You make some mistake in these two forms. You better watch out. Okay? When you punch, or you're doing something, in other hand, should be understood. Don't be sloppy. Each one make clearly. Slow down.
我其实我一直在想这个事情，到底是我的教课方式还是我招生方式，好像都出现问题。因为我教课的方式就是比较师傅传给徒弟制的，我没有一天让助教或者是 senior student 来去帮我教课，我都完全自己亲力亲为的。但是那个就是没有办法扩大。但是你如果当你教给副手的时候，你就竟然跟学生有一点间隔了，他对你只是好像是经营者而已，他没有想到说你是他的 Great Master。
在这里啊，我手指在这里啊，再过来一点。
现在很多人都是会这样的，哎，这个有什么差别？多一公分就多是两公分，为什么呢 ？Piggy， 但是你没有从先服从开始，你怎么有办法创造新的东西呢？
龙哥 ，and easier for you to push forward， 有些
我们以前教的跟这完全不一样的东西啊。我们教的是武术，啊，这边现在是教的是运动。一开始就有很多羞辱，我说，啊，怎么没有那个跆拳道精神？原来你们学这个东西只是为升级升带子。
A real martial artist would say that a belt just holds up your pants. It doesn't matter if you're a white belt, if you're a black belt, if you don't feel a sense of honor and duty.Then your belt means absolutely nothing.
如果是用这种角度的时候，当然是觉得很失望。但是另外一个角度是想说，人家又不是跟你走一样的路，人家又不是叫做 Great Master。
Well, it's a very tough job, not just for him, but for me as well. Every school needs a certain balance. Number one, we need to make sure that the school operates as a successful business that can run.Number two, we have to make sure that the students are learning. He is a very stubborn person, but his mind is still open. He can listen to ideas, and then he might change, he might not change, but he will listen.
这个之间的一个转折点里面，我还在调试中，我自己甚至也在矛盾中。现在目前的教的学生的方法我不会呀，所以我要 depend someone， 而这个人我觉得最适合就是 Master Shu， 因为他热爱。
I work in the financial industry, and that's really my life from Monday through Friday. And I always make it a point to make sure to come back to the school and try to pass on the things that I learned here.
Liam, come here, Liam. You're humongous.
Do I want to succeed Master Huang in this school? Yes, that would be a big honor. Is it something that I know that I can devote my entire life to, my entire week to? I'm not sure. As long as he wants me here, I will be here for him.
讲真的，我也很单纯的一个想法。我希望我教出来学生每个都像我一样，哎，有一种很彪悍的精神。看这个踢的也像我，我很高兴，好像把自己拉回自己的童年一样。我的身体一直很不好，从小就是常常被欺负。我父亲本身他是台大政治系毕业的，就譬如说去练武啦，提都不敢提了，就我就会去闹。他最后终于同意我去练跆拳道。虽然我爸爸过世26年，每一次我提到我爸爸的时候，我不晓得怎么讲下去。我爸爸中风，躺在床上，前面6年都是我在照顾，他很依赖我，所以他一直不希望我来。但是一回到台湾的时候，有一个黑人学生在墙上跟着我说：“你要赶快开啊，我们等你啊。”有几分责任感，那又几分是说，好像自己觉得我自己很伟大。我爸爸快过世的最后一面，那一天晚上他走了，我去给他握着手说：“爸爸，我要回去纽约了，你自己好好保重。”我要走的时候一直看着我，我看他眼睛红红的，他跟我讲“回来”两个字。讲到这些的时候，有时候自己十分的感伤。父亲当他需要我的时候，我竟然离他而去。我好像背弃了父亲。我每次遇到什么困境，我会跪在他相片前默思这样子。他给我的教义：勇往直前，铜墙铁壁你也可以打穿得过去。当我跟他报告完站起来的时候，我充满了勇气。这就是他给我的精神。父母亲在的时候，你总会觉得说还有明天，再过几年，再过几年。常常想说，如果我没有来，会什么历史会不一样？也许我爸可以多活几年，也许我就不会有这么多愧疚感，夜夜做梦。所以你如果再重来一次，你会不会选择这一行业？我说不会，这个就是其中最重要的原因。
人生就是就像一个单行道，只有往前走，没有往后看的。
失去是永远没办法弥补的情感，但是你就是一个思想说，我要坚持下去，我要往前走，即使前面的路我不晓得，你即使你现在正在受苦中，你还是会往前走，就像苦行僧一样，你会继续往前走。
Today we have 39 students taking the promotion test. You all try very hard already.But unfortunately, several people who failed.
不管怎么样，我希望你们今天经过这次考试的时候，每一个都有所收获，又有那种杀气出来。哎呀 ，Even the wood, the stone, I want to get back. Mentality, you have to focus. You look forward only.
Conversation.
Good job.To be honest, teaching the moves, the motions, the kicking, the punching, that's all very easy stuff for us. We can do that in our sleep because we've been doing this for right now 32 years here. It's working with every student as individuals and also as a classroom to teach them the real foundation of martial arts. Respect, courtesy, having a strong heart, confidence, confidence in yourself as well as your fellow classmates. Yes, this day is always one of our proudest days, and one of the sad days also, because this is almost like a school graduation. Then today they get their black belts and it's like graduating. A lot of them will stay on, but we know that most of them will leave also.
Congratulations, you did a very good job. Yeah, very very good job. I proud of you.
其实跆拳道是一种奉献，是一种牺牲，是精神的传承。
It's a legacy. It's a legacy. There are very few schools, in this era, even in the world, that can say that they've survived for 32 years.
Okay, sing a song. Hey, happy birthday for 32 years old. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.Happy birthday to Taekwondo School. Happy birthday to you.
在切蛋糕的时候都是接受恐惧的。原来你理想跟年龄还是有关系。练武的人到底有限制的。我跟 Master Xu 在讲这一句话。我说我不能硬撑着，我只能做这一个 consultant 的一个工作了。
I think knowing Mas Wan just the way that he is, knowing his martial arts spirit and his personality, I think as long as he can walk, he will be here.
这是很好玩的事情，但是你看，几十年了，这一辈子啊，不是几十年，一辈子就在这地方打滚的。啊，你叫我说离开跆拳道，我很难晃下去。
Thank you。
OK， 拜拜。
你看，是舍不得，而不是不能。我自己本身是热爱这个运动，但是我现在已经开始要考虑要说如何下这个台阶。我很资深的一个学生，也是我很重要的教练，他本来自己出去开道馆，现在回来帮我，他把那学生带回来我们这边练习这样子。Hello， yeah， help see first， 真的是像自己的儿子一样了。那我实在是想了好几年了，本来我有一个 master shoe 在左手，现在又多一个右手，所以等到明年我要大展宏图，哈哈。